so I want a relationship that gives a romance novel a run for its money. And this is how I can tweak my partner to being exactly what I want. I would say 110%. And so you have what are called projecting seeds and finishing seeds. Projecting seeds are like what you planted by visiting the old lady. This is what throws the boy into your life. And then you have finishing seeds. These are his details. What type of qualities do I want to see in him? And it's kind of like Michelangelo, when he painted the Sistine Chapel, he went in and drew all the outlines, made indications of the colors, and then his apprentices came in and filled in all the details. So what do you want in your partner? And it really is like a wish list. It's good to make a list. Kind of like if you were buying a new car, which I did last year, and I wanted, you know, heater seats. I wanted mirrors that would heat up so I didn't have to wait for the defrost. I wanted it to be silver. I wanted a certain interior. And it's the same with your partner. And for each quality that you want to see, you can plant a specific seed for that quality. And the good news is that seeds are like potatoes. You plant one and it grows. You put a potato on the ground, get lots of potatoes. So you do one small action and it plants big results. And you know, I did a lot of videos online about how the system works, because the more that you understand how it works, the quicker you can get your results. And this is a very brief presentation. So I encourage you to, if you're interested, go learn more, because then it'll make more sense. But these are some of the most common correlations that you can see. So loving, obviously if you have a husband or a wife, well, husband if you call it here, you want them to love you. That's pretty apparent. So how do you plant that seed? That's by appreciating other people around you. And you can do this during your coffee meditation, or you can verbally show them, thank you Kelly, I appreciate you filming. So that plants a seed for me to have a loving partner. And now, you may have a partner who loves you, but maybe he also really likes his computer or climbing more than he likes giving me hugs. So I want to plant an affectionate partner. And this is really easy to do, and it's just smiling at the people you meet. Okay, this is all you have to do. Ready? Ready?
Hi.
Hi.
That's it. I just planted seeds for an affectionate partner.
Hi.
Okay, then obviously, you want a loyal partner, so keep your promises and appointments. Which is really funny, because today I had an appointment to turn the car in to get fixed, and I completely forgot about it. So I have to clean that seed, which we're not talking about here today, but if you want to know, we can talk about it later. So if you want a loyal partner, keep promises and appointments. Listens to me. Important for students, I think. You want them to listen to you. Or for your partner. You want to be heard. It's a basic fundamental need. So what do you do in this case? You try and pay attention to other people's needs. I was recently at a monastery, and we surprised the person there, went in, and they followed my eyes to see what I was looking at. And you know, I'm looking at the pretzels. And they ran over and got me the pretzels, or they got me a cup of tea because they saw me looking at it. They were paying attention to my needs. And this plants the seed for people and your partner to listen to you. And obviously we all want a good looking partner, come on. If we can have it all, why not have it all? And this seed is not getting angry with anyone for any reason. Definitely easier said than done, but it plants the seed for your partner to be good looking. One lady, actually, she really loved her husband, but his ears were too big. So she said, is there anything I can do about his ears? So she, you know, she worked on being more patient. And then we went back there and we're like, oh, how's the ear thing? She's like, what ear thing? My husband's ears are fine. And she really had changed his ears. It's really amazing. And as a bonus, if you practice this, you also get better looking. So it's cheaper than going to Sephora. And then you also want an intelligent partner. You know, you want to be with somebody who can keep up with you. So this seed you plant by sharing what you know. And you guys, I think, are in a great position for this because you're teachers. You're sharing what you know all the time. And then also you want a partner who's capable. So how you do this, you want a partner who can get things done, is by taking responsibility to see that things get done. For instance, we had to do a talk, so my mom took responsibility to make sure we got a venue to do a talk. And then also, I think it's important, you know, if you're interested in spiritual stuff, that you and your partner can be on the same page. So how you plant this seed is by looking for the magic in the world, in things or in other people. And it works really well if you can do it with people you don't like. Like maybe you're like, well, maybe the president is doing something magical. I don't understand it, but maybe he is. So, and these, you know, these are just a small list. You know, maybe you don't see the quality that you want up here. Like, I really want a partner who loves washing the dishes. So how do I plant a seed for that? And the story doesn't have to end here. It's a small town, so feel free to bug us at any time. I put a lot of videos online. If you're interested, we're definitely available, and we're going to do more talks. We just did one on meditation in Durango for 2 days, and it was really successful. So now that you have everything, let's imagine that we are in a perfect relationship. What are you going to do? Are you just going to stay at home in your little fortress and you versus the world, or can you actually help the whole world? So,
helping the whole world sounds like a big task. Putting on our superhero suits, spandex, you know, I don't know, might show a little bit too much. So there are more simple ways to help the world once you have a partner. And this topic is called the three glasses of water. So we had an example, Susie in Las Vegas, I think was her name. She went out and, you know, it was the pink lipstick and it was visiting the old lady. And those two things helped her snare this wonderful boy. Snare maybe sounds like a little bit conniving, but she actually was able to get a great partner. And then what is Susie going to do to keep that partner? She's going to practice her own loyalty. We talked about that, keeping her own morality, not staring at other guys or flirting. Right? And so she found him. She kept him. She made him perfect using some of Katie's techniques with the great correlations. So now he does dishes. He cleans the house. He picks up the kids. No, he doesn't pick up the kids yet, actually, because their romance is newer. And so it's to the point where she wants to introduce this boy to her friends because he's very good looking and she's been single for a long time, but she feels confident enough now to introduce her new boyfriend to the girls. So she asks the girls if they would come to the pizza parlor at 5:30. She's gonna introduce her new guy, but she doesn't tell him that. And then she asks him, would you come and meet me at my apartment at 5:30 so that I can take you out and introduce you to the girls? So he agrees. When he gets to the apartment, she says, great, we're gonna go meet the girls for pizza, but first I need you to drink these three glasses of water. And he's like, why? And she said, honey, if you love me, would you please just drink these glasses of water? So this guy is so great that he doesn't even question her about it anymore. He just grabs the water and glug, 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 and gets himself to force all this water down. So then they run off to the pizza parlor. If you remember, the girls have been sitting there since 5:30, and they've been sitting talking amongst themselves, and they're looking over towards the door because they're wondering why you have not gotten there yet after inviting everybody. So they see you walk in, Susie, walk in with this guy who looks like Brad Pitt, and they're like, oh my goodness, she must have brought her cousin with her, because Susie's been single for so long, they don't even think that it could be a boyfriend. So Susie and Brad, or whatever his name is, walk up to the table, and she asks him to give her a kiss. And he gives her a big romantic kiss at the table. And all of the girlfriends are like, wow, I guess that's not the cousin after all. And they all sit down. A little bit of small talk goes on at the table. And then Brad has to go in and use the facilities because he drank all this water. So this is the big moment. He goes, excuses himself to go to the restroom. And the girls are like, where did you get this guy? Did you go to the nightclub? Did you go internet dating? And Susie says, no, I went to the old folks' home. And they said, well, he looks so young. And she said, no, didn't meet him. He wasn't one of the residents, right? And then this is her chance to tell her friends about the four steps and about the pen, so that they can learn that what they think, say, and do is going to shape their world. Because it's not just the pen that can be seen as a chew toy or as my favorite pen, but it's everything around us. It's our relationships, it's money, our job, our friendships. So everything is affected by what we think, say, and do. And so when Susie gets the chance to share that, one of her friends is going to be desperately lonely enough to be crazy enough to actually try these techniques. And be like, well, I heard about it. What do I have to lose? Because the nightclub didn't work out so well. The internet dating hasn't worked for me either. So what do I have to lose by trying to be nice to other people or help somebody else get what I want? The worst thing that could happen is you might be a nicer person. So you really don't have a lot to lose. So that's how we can affect the world around us. And I'm excited that I came to Silverton this time, because your town is so small. I was thinking about, what if 10% of the people in this town tried out some of these techniques? You know, the whole town could change, actually, from people thinking about how to help other people to get what they want. So I think Katie's got a demonstration.